Hi, welcome to the session on CMA Part 2, Financial Decision Making. In this session, we'll discuss about the marginal analysis, in which we'll discuss about different types of costs, cost objects, and cost drivers. Different types of costs as well. The costs in a manufacturing industry are of different types. According to their behavior, we classify them into fixed costs, variable costs, and mixed costs. Fixed costs are those which remain constant in a relevant period, like rent of the factory. The relevant period is, say, 1 year tenancy contract. During this period, the rent is fixed, $120,000. So the tenancy contract begins on January 1st, ends on December 31st. So during this 12 months time, the amount of fixed cost does not change. That is called fixed cost. And this time period from January to December is called a range, relevant range. Within that period, you can't expect any kind of increase or decrease in this rent. It is a fixed cost. Variable cost. Variable cost varies according to the production. When the production goes up, the cost will also go up. Like you are purchasing material at the rate of $5 per kg. To produce a product A, we need 10 kgs of material. One unit of A requires 10 kgs. So one unit needs 10 kgs of raw material at the rate of $5. So the cost is going to be $50 on material to produce product A. When you produce the same product, say for example, A, 20 units. 20 units times 10 kgs of material equals to 200 kgs times $5 will cost you $1,000. See, as the production increases, the cost will increase. As the production increases, the cost will increase. Such a cost is called as variable cost. Variable cost fluctuates according to the production. It goes up when the production capacity goes up. It goes down when the production decreases. Whereas semi-variable or semi-fixed is called as mixed cost, wherein you have some portion of the cost fixed and the remaining portion is variable. Variable. Same cost has some portion fixed, some portion variable, then it is called fixed cost. Like utility charges, electricity bill, maybe like $200 per month is fixed, plus $1.2 per unit consumed. See, electricity bill is a cost here. It is a mixed cost because it has a fixed portion and a variable portion. The number of units you consumed will help you to understand the total bill for a particular month. So it has the electricity bill has two components here, fixed portion and variable portion. Such a cost is called as mixed cost. Mixed cost is also known as semi-fixed or semi-variable. In a marginal analysis, we do not consider the mixed costs. The costs are classified into only fixed and variable. Fixed and variable. And we call it as total cost. So Fixed cost plus variable cost will give us total cost. Fixed cost, say $5,000. Variable cost, say $5 per unit times 200 units produced. $5 per unit times $200 units produced is going to be $1,000. So the total cost of producing 200 units is $6,000. Always remember, variable cost you will get only when you multiply the variable cost per unit times the quantity produced. So here the total cost is 6,000. When you calculate average cost per unit, ACP, average cost per unit, total cost is divided by the total quantity produced, the total units produced. That is going to be $30 per unit. This is called average total cost, average cost per unit. Average total cost is further split into average fixed cost and average variable cost. So here, average cost per unit is given here, yeah, $30. Now, what is average fixed cost and average variable cost? Average fixed cost equals to only the fixed cost divided by number of units produced. That is $5,000 divided by number of units produced, 200. So it is going to be $25. Average variable cost equals to total variable cost, that is $1,000 divided by number of units produced, 200 equals to $5. So average total cost, average fixed cost, average variable cost are used in our marginal analysis to maximize the profit. When you calculate average cost per unit, it will be helpful in our marginal analysis when average variable cost rises or falls as a production increases. The average fixed cost will decline continuously. Variable fixed cost, the average fixed cost will decline continuously. How? In the previous example, I gave you that the fixed cost was $5,000. Okay? When you produce 200 units, the fixed cost was $25 per unit. When you produce 250 units, the production increases, it is going to be $20 per unit. So as the production increases, the fixed cost per unit will decrease. Okay. So when you have a production capacity efficiently used, producing a maximum extent, that will result in decrease in fixed cost. You will enjoy a profit of the decrease in fixed cost. So when a production continuously increases, you will see an impact on your fixed cost that will gradually decrease. That is a great benefit to the manufacturers when they produce more and more units